it's Judy. Welcome to my channel. And today I am reviewing the MUA Luxe range that I have bought through Superdrug. I have been playing with these products for about a week now, and I have my likes and my dislikes. If you would like to find out what I think of all of the products and how I created this look, then please just keep watching. So, I'm going to start with primer, and I have this primer called the Pro Base Smooth Set and Prime. And it's, if you remember my my Bio Aqua video, I used a very similar thing, and I refer to it, it reminds me of the Benefit Dr. Feelgood. So it's that sort of balmy texture. This one doesn't come with a sponge, thank goodness. And I'm just going to spread that over the areas where issues, and then I've got this Color and Correct, what do they call it, balancing kit. So it has, once you open it up, it has a powder which works really well as a setting powder, and then underneath it a cream that cancels out some of the redness in my skin. So I find it also works quite well for the dark circles under my eyes. I'm going to use it under the foundation. My nose gets quite red this time of year with all of the wiping, so. He left her lonely with the diamond. And I'm just going to use my Real Techniques Beauty Blender, which I've dampened, and just blend that in. I've picked up the MUA Skin Define Matte Effect Foundation, and this is in the colour Ivory, yes, Ivory, which was the lightest colour that I could find on the Superdrug website. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a pump of that onto my beauty blender, but I also picked up the MUA Lightening, this is Custom Colour Foundation Mixer, and I've got it in Lightening Warm. They also do a Lightening Cool. So just a squirt of that foundation. Okay, I'll do two squirts of that foundation. And then I will just add about the same amount of the Lightening Cream. Brings the foundation back to my skin tone. And I do find that the foundation oxidizes a little bit, so it's quite useful to have a little bit of a mixer in it. Just move that around my beauty blender, see there, and then I'm just going to dot that over. It looks really white going on because at the moment the lightener is underneath, is over the top of the foundation. So I'm just going to blend that in all over my face. And if needs be, I can add a little bit more foundation to darken it up again. I'm trying to get this done before I lose all reasonable light. Looks quite cool on camera, but I think part of that is the light that I'm working with. It's now just after 5 o'clock in the afternoon in February. It's starting to get dark. I'm going to get this done. There we go, that's it blended in quite well. And then I have the bronzed shimmer stick, so I'm just going to use this to kind of warm up my face a bit. Quite a cool tone bronzer actually. The glitter goes a long way. Use my beauty blender to just blend that in. Try to remember to always blend your contour up. Now I did also pick up the foundation the custom color foundation mixer in Deepening Medium as well. So I could use that as a contour. Let's give that a shot and see what happens. Just a tiny amount. But if you've got a foundation that you've bought that is too light, then this medium will allow you to just darken it up a bit so you don't have to throw it away. That's quite good. And then I've picked up the MUA Luxe Light Lustre Liquid Highlighter. And this, does it have a colour? No, it doesn't have a colour. But it's a nice liquid highlighter. And it really is very, oops, blingy. It doesn't take much to get a really good effect. So I tap it on the top of my nose, then on my forehead. And then I'm just going to use my finger to blend that in to start off with, and then I'll probably go in with my beauty blender to just even it out. Well, we'll give it a try. I don't have any fantastic lighting rigs. This is just my phone that I've hooked up. So, yeah, I'm going to go back in with that beauty blender and just blend it out a bit. Now I'm going to go in with a big fluffy brush and take this colour and correct balancing kit that I used earlier. I used the cream of earlier, and I'm going to just take a dusting of this powder. This gives an awful lot of kickback, people. And I'm just going to powder down the areas where I don't want there to be any shine. So that would be across the outside, the inside of my cheeks, down to my chin, and actually a huge portion of my forehead that I've just spread my outer all over. So I'll just set everything in place, set that liquid bronzer in place. In the same range, there is the Bronze and Sculpt Contoured Kit. I'm just going to take this is a foundation brush, but I'm going to take, in the top of this, there is a shimmer, and in the bottom, there is a bronzer powder. So I'm just going to take the powder and set that powder bronzing stick, the shimmer stick that I used earlier, with just a bit more bronzer. And again, use my fluffy brush to buff that out. Now, in my opinion, my nose doesn't need to look any skinnier than it is. It's already quite long, so all I do is take a little bit these days and just tap it to the bottom of my nose. A little bit uncommon. And again, blend it out. And I'm going to take a little bit under my chin, give my jawline just a little bit of a definition. So, in the eyebrow department, I have two products. I have the powder, what do they call it? Power Brow 3-in-1 Brow Definer. And I also have their Power Brow Longwear Sculpting Brow Gel, which looks like a teeny tiny version of the L'Oreal one that I tried out in a previous video. So I'll just show you the difference. This one has a spoolie on one end, which is great for getting those brows nascent. And a tip on the other end that is retractable. So it's like the AliExpress one. And this one I find does a really good job for a daytime look. Not too pigmented, and just fills in those brows and makes them look a little fuller than mine are. And then the three bit is that in the middle here, there is a powder on a pencil type thing. And that just kind of sets that in place. So I would use that for a daytime look and for touch-ups. So that one goes into my purse and I carry it with me. This one is great for nighttime. Take it apart like the L'Oreal one, and I think like the Benefit one, but I've never used the Benefit one. And these are both in the color Chesnut. There are a range of colors available. So let's see. It just seems to darken it up, the whole brow up a bit. And if you want to, you can then go in and carve out the eyebrows with concealer. Now that I've done that, I think I need a little bit of blusher in. So I have here the MUA Luxe Bashful Blush Trio Palette 2. And it comes with three items in it. We have a matte bronzer, a shimmer bronzer, and a blush. Well, I think I've probably bronzed my face within an inch of its life. So I'm just going to use the blusher in here. That's a nice shimmer blusher. In winter, it's been a while, I've just started putting a little bit of blush up in my temples, because otherwise my face gets a little bit too grey. So then for eyeshadow, I have the MUA Luxe. This is Enrapture 5 Silk Eyeshadow Shades. And when you open it up, it's one of these blended pieces. And on camera, you can actually quite easily see the five shades. In real life, it looks a lot more blended. But basically, I'm going to start at one, and they're all, I wouldn't say they're shimmer shades, but they have a little bit of sparkle in them. So with me, I have to tread cautiously, or otherwise I start to look very wrinkly with them. So I'm just going to take a big fluffy brush, and I'm going into the lightest of the five colors. Again, quite a lot of kick up on these, but they are quite highly pigmented and they go quite a way. So. I'm going to go in with a slightly less fluffy brush, and I'm going into, I think, the middle of the five colors here, which seems to be a slightly more shimmery, and just take that into the crease. Can you see that kickback? There's lots of powder coming out of this, so I have to be careful that my nose doesn't end up looking grey because there's been fallout onto it. And then I'm going to go in with, this is a pencil brush, I'm going to go into that dark shadow there, and I'm just going to take that right into the outer V of my eye, and in a little bit across the top lash line, not too far. And blend that in with the previous brush. And then I'll go in with a fine line brush and go into this darkest color here, and I'm going to use it kind of like a little bit like an eyeliner. but only halfway because otherwise it'll make my eyes too small. And underneath that lower lash line as well. The nice thing I like about this particular, there is an awful lot of kick up, but what I do like about it is that the dark colour, this one here, that I don't use a huge amount of, is the smallest amount of colour in the palette. And this light colour that I will use more of is the largest in the palette, just simply because of the way it's laid out in the palette. So instead of having five uniform size shadows, I'm actually getting more of what I'll use more of and less of what I'll use less of. And then these three in between colours I will kind of chop and change with. So it's a useful thing, I think. Right, eyeliner. I'm going to take a small round brush and where's my eyeliner gone? There it is. I have the Precision High Definition Felt Liner. I don't get on very well with liquid liners, so this one is why I'm going to do this particular technique. So I'm going to take my liner and run it across the top line of my lash and see. And then while it's still wet, I'm just going to smudge it in. Same thing under. And actually that liner, this particular liner has been the most successful of all of the liquid liners that I've tried to get this particular look. Now it's not waterproof, which might be an issue, but so far it hasn't been too much of an issue, although I've only been trying it for a few days. So I then got the Eye Define Lengthening Mascara, and I did get the waterproof. They do a waterproof and a non-waterproof version. It says extends and elongates lashes to create a fuller look. Well, I'm not sure that I agree with that because I don't have many lashes to start off with. So but I quite like the way it makes my eyelashes look. What do you think? It's got a nice brush on the end of it. Plastic, but not too spiky, so it doesn't hurt, and it does separate out the lashes quite nicely. Okay, and then for lipstick, I have two colours that I bought. The first one, these are both the Longwear Matte Finish Lip Lacquers, and these are quite lacquery. Let's see if I can show you a swatch. So this one, this colour is called Tranquility, and then that's a nice nudie colour, and then this one is a deeper mauve, I guess you could call it, and it is called Hustle. So I think what I'll do is I'll put Tranquility on, you can see what that's like, and then I'll put Hustle on over the top. So Tranquility is a really nice colour for a daytime look. Dries down quite nicely. Once it's dry, it doesn't transition, much to my husband and child's joy. And this one is Hustle. So and then just to top it off. Oh, I almost forgot. I also got the Glow Beam Highlighting Powder in Cashmere. This is a one that probably won't go with me anywhere because it's in a silly container, but it's one of these ones that you turn and a small amount of powder comes out. So if I take a little bit of that and just set that highlighter that I did earlier. I actually find it's too dark to really be a highlighter. That kind of goes, it's almost a blush topper, I think. Yeah, that needs a bit of blending. And then finally, I have the Pro Base Mattifying Fixing Mist. This is not from the Luxe range. And at the moment on the Superdrug's website, if you order over a certain amount of MUA product, you will get a free standard finishing spray. I can show that to you. Hold on just a moment. You will get the Pro Base Fixing Spray for free. So if you would like to get that offer, then follow the link below in the description box and you will be able to qualify for this. Now, I will, in all honesty, put out that this is an affiliate link and I will earn a tiny amount of money from you clicking on that link and following it, but it will cost you nothing to follow that link and it will help me. So I will thank you and love you very much if you do that for me. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this look, the review of the products. What did I really like? I really like the finishing sprays. They are really nice finishing sprays. They seem to do a good job. Everything seems to hold in place nicely. I think I will get a lot of use out of the lightening and the darkening, custom color foundation mixes. I think these will be very useful, not just for my MUA stuff, but for some of my other foundations that I have that are either too light or too dark. I'm not hugely keen on the Glow Bar, the Glow Blam. I don't like the packaging, don't like the way it's not something that I will carry with me. And since I do an awful lot of my makeup on the go, this may not get a huge amount of use. I really quite like the highlighting drops. They are just amazing. The setting primer, I quite like. I'm not sure how much it gets into my pores, but then I don't have huge pores, so it's not a massive issue for me. I'm really enjoying the bronze and sculpt, but I'm finding that the bronzer in here, the bronzer and the sparkling bronzer, are not to my liking. They're just, the light one is too light to be a good contour shade and the dark one is too shimmery to be a good contour shade. But I'm really quite liking the blush once it's over the top of this bronzer. The Color and Correct Balancing Kit, I love this. I really like what the green cream does for all of my pinky bits on a day when I'm having problems with pinky bits. What else is there? The mascara I quite like. The lipsticks are very drying, so I have to use them at a time when my lips are not cracked, and this time of year is quite difficult to get that to happen. So overall, with regards to the MUA Luxe range, I would highly recommend it. So if you would like to avail yourself of this, get yourself down to Superdrug and I'm sure they'll be happy to help you out. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. It would really help me if you would subscribe and hit that notification bell to let people know that you do, so that you get notified every time I upload something. And otherwise, I hope that you're having a lovely February and I will see you in my next video. Bye.